Hi guys, this is Chris with Recombu, and I'm here with the Wileyfox Swift. Now you might not have heard of Wileyfox before, but they're a British manufacturer, and they just launched two new phones. We've got the £129 Swift, the more value offering, and the £199 Storm. So the whole point of the Swift is that basically it looks like a serious Moto G competitor, with the exception that it runs Cyanogen OS instead of straight up Android, so it's offering greater customizability and some more in-depth features there. And also, because it's a British firm, it means that basically you can get local support if you have any issues with it. It's going to be online only, and pre-orders go on sale this week, and it should be hitting stores in sort of the end of September. So let's check out the Swift. So a nice little orange box, little ribbon as well. Very nice bit of detail there. Let's just take that off. Let's see if we can get this bad boy open. Oh, hey, there we go. Oh, here's you go, Sam. Excellent. I'll nick that. So here we go. So this is the Wileyfox. The Wileyfox Swift. Let's prize this open. There it is. Sat there in the box. Very snug in the box. Okay, so let's see. Hopefully we'll have some charge already in there. Yeah, brilliant. Okay, so that's loading up. So the Wileyfox Swift, it's a 5-inch smartphone, so the same size as the Moto G, the new Moto G, which I've got handily here. So as you can see, it's more or less the same size. It feels a little bit slimmer. Although maybe that's just because the Moto G is basically has this more sort of rounded back, whereas the Wileyfox is quite sort of flat in general. So there we go, Cyanogen OS. It runs Cyanogen 12.1 over the top of Android Lollipop 5.1. It's quite a nice sort of smooth textured back, nice soft touch to it. The Wileyfox logo there, quite cool. So let's see if it's loading up, still going strong. So yeah, the 5-inch screen is a 720p display, so again comparable to the Moto G, and it also runs the Snapdragon 410 processor with 2 GB of RAM in it. So kind of hoping that Cyanogen's going to run nice and smooth on it, and we'll find out when it finally loads up, because it's just doing the general setup right now. On the front of it, you have a 5-megapixel selfie camera, and on the back, you've got a 13-megapixel with a dual LED flash. So again, comparable to the Moto G, which rocks the same 13 megapixel camera found in the Nexus 6, which came out last year, which at, you know, the price of the Moto G is absolutely fantastic. That's a great camera. So we'll have to fully test out the Wileyfox Swift and see if that 13 megapixel camera is just as strong. But certainly in terms of specs, it is pretty much directly comparable. So yes, you get 16 gigabytes of storage built into it. And there's also a micro SD memory card slot. So if we can prize this thing open. Here we go, here's the little thing. Prize off the back, there we go. So as you can see, it's dual SIM. Both SIMs support 4G, we've been told. So that's great news if you're a business user as well as a personal user, you just want one device. Obviously not a big thing in the UK, so we're kind of surprised to see it. It's more of a thing that you find in Asian markets, for instance, but it's always good to have. And there you have the micro SD memory card slot as well. And so I think it's a 2500 milliamp battery as well, which is fully removable, which obviously we won't remove now because that'll just screw it all up. So let's put that back into place, just snaps neatly in there. No water resistance or anything, sadly, but unlike the Moto G, which does come with full water resistance. But to be honest, it's nice and slim and light. Quite like the design of it so far. Speakers are there at the bottom, got the two outputs there. And of course the bog standard micro USB charging. I don't think it's the latest version of that. So yeah, overall, a very nice and slim and light phone. At 5 inches, the screen does pretty much stretch edge to edge. So it feels like it'll be nice and easy to use one-handed, which is always good. So this is obviously going to be taking a little while to charge up. So maybe we'll do some video magic and zip straight to it when it's fully loaded. Ooh. Ooh. Oh, look, it worked. Right, brilliant. We've got Cyanogen OS. So this is the Cyanogen account setup. So basically, you set up your own account, you can create your own themes and share them with people and do all kinds of stuff. The live caller ID is really cool. Basically, I think they said that it was something like 1.7 million numbers they've got stored in there, including a bunch of spam numbers and stuff. So if you're constantly getting those bloody PPI calls, you can basically cut all those out. It'll tell you exactly who's calling, as long as the number is registered on the database. So that's great news. So I will create one of those later. So that allows you to browse and download the themes. And also you can do, remote phone location as well, which is always handy. So this is sitting on top of Android Lollipop 5.1. It basically has most of the usual Android features. As you can see right now, it's got a familiar sort of look and feel to it. But also the themes is a big part of it. You can basically download so many themes from it and create your own. And you can also mix and match as well. So for instance, if you like the wallpaper on one theme, but you don't like the icons, you can do the icons of one and the backgrounds of another. So that's a really cool little feature. So yeah, so at a quick glance, there is Cyanogen OS. Certainly seems to be, just from a super quick play, running absolutely perfectly fine, nice and smooth. But we'll be doing a full hands-on test with it and giving you a full review as well in a few days once we've used it as our own personal handset. So check back for that soon. Okay, cheers guys.